You are listening to the Eagles Podcast Network. This is the College Sports Podcast. I'm Ethan Bass, and welcome to our NFL special. Today, I am joined by the CS Senior Insider, Jordan Tunick, for the NFL. Welcome to the show, Jordan.
Hey, I'm just glad to be here. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. Today, we have you on a conference call today, because we are not in the studio again since the whole coronavirus, and gently going into coronavirus again. We're not going to do our college normal episode today. Again, this will be an NFL episode. So going in through the coronavirus, teams in like LA and around California, the West Coast, have been talking about NFL teams going into college stadiums. So and so the governor of Florida, Ron DeSantis, has stated that if any NFL team wants to play in Ben Hill Griffin Stadium, which is the University of Florida stadium, that they could play in it an alternative to their stadium. So, Jordan, what do you think about NFL teams playing like in college stadiums? Like, how does that feel?
I feel like it's a good idea, but at the same time, with the colors and stuff, like, for example, like Ben Hill Stadium, orange and blue, it might give advantage to like all those Florida teams, because maybe Jacksonville, Miami, all those teams down there.
And like going off on that, on these universities, you're obviously not going to be all fans of that certain team. So that can also include a home field advantage for the other team. But teams have been talking about, or like the NFL and the college commissioners have been talking about not having fans at all. So maybe that will lift that fan thing problem. But I'm just very interested to see what that will look like. It'll be very cool, to be honest, just seeing an NFL an NFL team play in the college stadium as their hometown. We'll see about that, though. Something really interesting, though, is this NFL past offseason, though. We saw a lot of stuff going on in this offseason, but probably the most interesting part of the whole offseason was the evolution of the NFC South, right?
Correct. NFC South.
So, yeah.
Especially the Buccaneers have made a lot of big changes with Gronkowski, of course, and Tom Brady himself. They have a good connection. I feel like Tom Brady's having a good year because all these good wide receivers, Mike Evans, Chris Godwin, Gronk, I think it's going to be a good fit for him.
Yeah, I can agree with that because, like, I think it's going to be a very good fit because Gronk, again, has been playing with Tom Brady for who knows how long, like 7 years, right? Something like that. But then the Saints grew too, and then the Panthers fired their head coach and hired Baylor's head coach and Matt Rule, so that should be interesting. And then the Falcons add Todd Gurley. So, I mean, who is your prediction? I'm going to start with my prediction first, going on from 4-1. Number four, I have the Carolina Panthers. Here's why. They hired a new coach in Matt Rule and stuff. Do you agree with the Carolina Panthers at four?
At four? Oh, fourth place?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, 100%. I thought
you said first. No, I didn't. But anyways, Carolina going on four, I predict they'll be fourth in the division because of they got a new coach and Matt Rule. And they also, Cam Newton is out and Bridgewater is in. So we'll see how Bridgewater performs. But they have Christian McCaffrey, who is a Pro Bowl back. I mean, you can't argue that. But, like, Luke Kuechly, retirement, I mean, that was a pretty – weird, and that was weird.
Yeah.
And then this off season they moved Eric Reed, which is red or something, the safety, which is pretty off, which is pretty interesting. So going on in the number three spot, I'm picking the Atlanta Falcons, and here's why. You know Matt Ryan, Todd Gurley, and Julio Jones is gonna be an insane offense, but I think that top two teams are just going to be better than them. You know, they played the top two teams. You're going to find that out soon. But the top two teams four times and stuff. Yeah.
Do you feel like Julio Jones still has it in him? Like, for the past 2 years, he hasn't been himself. Do you think he can do this this year? He can build back up and become a better player than he used to be?
It's going to be kind of tricky, and here's why. Again, this offseason is so weird that players can't be in workouts and stuff. Players can't practice with each other. And players can't learn stuff. So it's going to be kind of tricky. I don't think so, but I think Todd Gurley is going to really take over in Atlanta. I think he's going to become the new star.
Right.
But I don't know about Julio, since it's just a challenging offseason that who knows, like even the most surprising player can either like a great player or terrible player can either decline or incline. So I mean, you don't know. And do you think that he's gonna do better?
I agree with you. I don't think he'll. I feel like he'll still be the bust. I feel like he, of course, it's Julio Jones, but Tom Gurley,
he's not a bust though. Like he's good. He's a good, solid player.
We all know though that he was one of the top five wide receivers. He's just not that material anymore. Like you said, Tom Gurley, I feel like he's gonna take over. I just feel like he's gonna get a lot of reps. That's all.
We'll see. We will see. I mean, the Falcons are a very interesting team. They are one of the teams who got the new uniforms. And going on to the number two spot, I got the New Orleans Saints. Now, for all of you who are surprised here, yes, the Saints, we saw them fluke in the playoffs last year. And a lot of people are saying, you know, Saints are going to win the Super Bowl every year. This has been the case for the past 2 or 3 years. And I just don't know anymore because, like, the Saints, again, they have one of the best quarterbacks of all time in Drew Brees and stuff. They also have Michael Thomas, who's probably the best wide receiver in the game. But and they also have good defense, but I just think the team above them is now better. What do you think?
I mean, I'll have to disagree with you on that. Of course, obviously you're putting Buccaneers number one. I understand why you put them there, because obviously the new additions. However, I feel like it won't, at first, it's going to be hard to settle in. I feel like Saints and Buccaneers are both playoff teams. Saints, like you said, they always say they want Super Bowl, but they never do. But I feel like they're still that top three, maybe top
four. I agree. I think that they're very elite in the regular season, but when it comes to the postseason, they need some work, seriously. Mm-hmm. And going on to our number one spot, I have the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. He got the Saints, right?
Yeah, I got the Saints.
So I got the Buccaneers for these reasons. Number one, that they have Tom Brady now, the greatest quarterback of all time, in my opinion, and probably a lot of people's opinions. They added Gronkowski. They probably had the most lethal offense in the game. Well, one of them. With Mike Evans, Chris Godwin, O.J. Howard, Cameron Brate, and now Gronkowski with Brady. I mean, that's just lethal.
Let me ask you something.
Yeah.
What do you think these teams' records will be, starting from Carolina?
Carolina, it's kind of hard to tell. I'm gonna guess 6-8. Am I doing that math correct?
Really?
Yeah.
I think they've got 5 wins. Yeah, around 5-6, I'd say.
It's hard to tell with these lower teams.
Yeah, I agree.
Sorry, not 6-8. I'm sorry, because that week go 14. Sorry, it'll be 6-10. Sorry about that.
Did not mean to do that. Okay.
Anyways, going on to the Atlanta Falcons, I've seen them going up. I see them with around 8-9 wins. How about you?
8-9 wins.
Yeah, for the Atlanta Falcons.
I would say they're only the same as Carolina, maybe 6.
Seven, maybe?
Maybe 7. You're ranking them surprisingly high. All they really got, which is a really good add, is Todd Gurley.
They're still an elite team, though. I mean,
they are an elite team, correct. However, I don't think they got 9 wins in them.
I don't know. We'll see. All right, going on to the Saints here. I think that they'll get 11 wins. How about you? 11 to 12 wins for the Saints.
I think a solid 12.
Yeah.
Wins will be good for them.
Same thing with the Buccaneers. With the Buccaneers, I see them winning the exact same number of wins, or close to that. But the Buccaneers will win on two of the matchups or something. But that's why I have them ahead. But we'll see. It's gonna be a very interesting NFC South this year. Do you agree with that?
I agree. Okay, yeah. Ask one more thing.
Yeah. What's up?
How far do you think the Bucs can go in the playoffs? If they make the playoffs, which you think they will, how far?
That's too hard. Again, Brady's pretty old, but again, you just wonder. I mean, there's a lot of old people. If you saw in the NHL, Jaromir Jagr was there. He was performing good numbers at 43. I mean, that was insane. But I see them potentially going to the Super Bowl. I see them getting that motivation. The Super Bowls and Tampa. I mean, it's hard to tell, but I see them going pretty deep, as well as the Saints. I see them matching up sometime, but it's going to be pretty interesting.
All right.
All right, now moving on to Jordan's hometown team, the Miami Dolphins. All right, so Tua Tagovailoa. I said that completely wrong, but Tua, I can't say his last name. But Tua, going to the Dolphins. I'm a big college guy, obviously, the podcast, because we record the college. But I'm a big college guy, so I saw him in Alabama play throughout his career. And he just looked amazing before that injury. But how do you feel like that Tua's injury could affect the Miami Dolphins quarterback play?
I feel like it's a great pick. Honestly, watching the draft, obviously he could have gone to the Chargers. No one really knew. But as soon as they made that call, I was really excited and stuff. But however, with the injuries, probably over six injuries maybe, all these ACL torn. He hasn't played since his ACL, if I'm correct, around like 2018.
Yeah. No, wait. No. He broke his ACL this year. When Nick Saban put him in when he shouldn't put him in, but that's a whole different discussion. But Tua, it seems like he is recovering, but we're not sure. Again, these injuries could be very fatal. What?
He has to say he's 100%.
He has to.
But no one knows if that's for real until we see it on the field.
Do you think Brian Flores is an elite coach?
I mean, obviously he was from Patriots, a defensive coach, I believe.
Yeah.
So just go straight to head coach. It's a big move up for him. I feel like the ad for Tua was a great move. I know it's probably high risk, high reward for him.
We'll see. I mean, the Dolphins could also be interesting. Basically, it's a wide open division now.
It's
because
a really big offseason this year. Really big offseason.
It's a wide open division, so we'll see.
For record, I would say around 7, maybe 8 wins.
Them placing second in the division.
Bills first.
Dolphins. Pats and Jets.
Jets last. Yeah. That's my prediction.
And probably the most average NFL fan can probably make that prediction too, because I mean the Patriots lost basically a lot of their offense and their draft picks were pretty bad. Huh?
They still have one of the best defenses.
Agreed. So I have a little off-topic question here. Off-topic from the Dolphins here. What do you think about the Chiefs returning? Again, they won a Super Bowl. Do you think they can repeat it again?
Great question. I feel like they have a shot. Definitely going to be – I don't think they're going to be wild card. I think they're going to go straight to a bye week.
Yeah.
I feel like the farthest they go is the semifinals. If they get to the Super Bowl, they'll win it. They haven't really made any changes. They haven't really added or lost.
Which is good and bad because it's pretty good, though. Like,
I think it's more good than bad because, yeah. I mean, they won last year, so if they didn't make any losses or additions, then that means they should be the same, right?
True.
That's how I see it.
Patrick Mahomes is the best quarterback in the game, in my opinion, right now. So, And also with the Ravens, one last question on the show here. We have to cut a little early today. But one last question on the show is that, will Lamar Jackson repeat his MVP season?
That's come up a lot to me, actually. I feel like next year, he will not be the same. Cause I feel like people will know how to shut him down. Year was his real, like, full year playing, like, as a starter.
Yeah.
He was crazy. But as soon as the playoffs started, he got destroyed by Derrick Henry. Like, all that. The Titans, you know, shut him down real good. They knew how to play him. So I feel like he won't be the same. He'll definitely be like a top 10 quarterback still, of course.
Yeah.
But he won't be the MVP material this year, no.
Yeah, I think Derrick Henry will shine again. But I think that Lamar Jackson is still going to be pretty amazing, like a top 5 quarterback in the game right now. But, like, I'm just wondering if they – I'm wondering how deep they can go in the playoffs.
Playoff-wise – I feel like they'll be like around the same. They'll probably be a bye week again for them. They're still a very good team, very good quarterback, very good team. However, I feel like they'll get the bye, and then I feel like they'll just get shut down again.
Like, true. Right off the bat. Yeah.
That's how I feel. I'm not sure. I mean, I'm sure all people have different opinions, but however, that's how I feel.
I agree with you. All right, thank you guys for joining us on this episode of the podcast. Again, if you guys would like to see another NFL episode, please. Put in the comments below. I'm Ethan Bass.
Jordan Kunick.
We're signing off. Thank you guys for joining.